See, I told you, the teachers are getting the things. Yeah. Oh, where is it? Oh, my gosh.
Thank you. Oh, it's nice to meet you. Is it? Where's Steve?
Oh, yeah. the ropes.
Sure.
Is
that
Thank you. evening. On behalf of the Penn-Argyl Area School District, faculty, staff, administration, and board of directors, I welcome you to the 120th commencement exercises for the graduates of Penn-Argyl Area High School. We are pleased you are here to witness and celebrate this final event for the class of 2019. This time, if everyone would please take the opportunity to silence their cell phones. Thank you. Before the national anthem, I'd like any member of the armed forces who has served, is currently serving, or has recently enlisted to please stand and be recognized. Your service, sacrifice, and commitment is the reason we're able to have ceremonies such as this, and we will be eternally grateful for all you have done for the United States of America. Thank you. At this time, our concert band, under the direction of Mr. Reike, will lead us in honoring the United States of America by playing our national anthem. If the audience would please rise. Gentlemen, remove your caps. Graduates, please be seated. So many have contributed so much to this evening's ceremony, and over the past 13 years, it would be impossible to recognize and thank them all without taking away from this evening's purpose. When the opportunity presents itself, please take a moment to thank all of those who have helped make tonight such a wonderful experience. I will take a moment to thank and recognize our school board of directors, Superintendent Mr. Wally Schlegel, District Assistant Superintendent Dr. Margaret Pettit, Penn-Argyl Area High School Assistant Principal Mr. Jason Oakley, Senior Class Advisor Ms. Cheryl Hance, and Junior Class Advisor Ms. Krista Campbell. Without their support, dedication, and commitment to providing our students with the best education, none of this would be possible. On behalf of all the graduates, thank you for your contributions to the success of the class of 2019. Certainly, the group of people who have had the greatest academic influence on these graduates over their years in Penn-Argyl Area School District are the teachers, administrators, and staff in each of the district's three buildings. Their hard work and dedication to educating our students is truly appreciated. I would like to recognize the following teachers who will be retiring this year. Ms. Carol Piccolo, Plainfield Elementary School. Mr. Salvatore Sortino, Wingap Middle School. Ms. Roxanne Stevens, Wingap Middle School. And everyone's favorite elementary school principal, Mr. Phil Giaquinto. And finally, on a personal note, I would like to thank Mrs. Weaver, Ms. Pagoda, Ms. Kessler, Ms. Strauss, Mr. Green, and whose time, energy, and commitment to our students has made this evening's events all come together. Before I introduce the class president, the class of 2019, I'd like to take a moment to remember all the loved ones we have lost and who could not be here with us this evening. Mothers, fathers, grandparents, friends, and two students of the class of 2019 that left us far too early in life, Jonathan Antinoli and Santino Tomorrow. Their presence is symbolized by their cap and gown to my right. I am certain all those we have lost are watching over us this evening and smiling. At this time, it's my privilege to introduce President of the Class of 2019 to welcome the audience and the Class of 1969 with a speech titled, The Next Hill on Your Journey, Mr. Nathan Dale.
Welcome. I would like to welcome the parents and families of the students who we would literally not be here without. Welcome to the teachers and administration who have educated us in their subject matter as well as taught us valuable life lessons. Then, of course, welcome to the class of 1969, Green Knights who walked these same halls before us. After today, we will join them as fellow alumni. And finally, welcome to the students. We have worked hard for these past 4 years, learning every subject thrown at us. We have accepted one of the biggest challenges life has to offer and conquered it. We finally made it to graduation, a day many of us probably thought would never come. It is a day of celebration that we may now leave high school and begin our lives. Now we stand facing another challenge. For some, this might mean college, while others may join the military or into the workforce. We each have our own set of challenges to overcome, but I feel that our school has given us the tools to face our challenges head on. As we continue along our paths, there will always be mountains or hills to climb. When you reach the top of that mountain, the view is often worth the time spent climbing. So push on and aim for greatness. I would like to say thank you to the teachers who pushed us towards that greatness and put up with us these past 4 years. They have been patient and compassionate, as well as tough. One thing I realized recently is that it is not just our parents who have watched us grow up, but also the teachers. They have devoted their lives to education, to teaching the future generation. I encourage you all to thank your teachers for the time and effort they put in for you. I'd like to ask you to take a few seconds to think back on all the memories you have had in high school, both good and bad. For me, I thought about the time I spent on school trips with my friends, the countless hours I spent in marching band, the long dress rehearsal days, and hours spent practicing for concerts, as well as all the teachers and what they have done for me. What I want to emphasize is that these experiences and memories that we have had in high school shape who we are and who we will be. Maybe a great engineer, an astronaut, or even President of the United States. I am lucky that I am able to share the memory of graduation with all of you today. These memories will be all that is left of our time here at Penn Argyl. We will soon be part of the Penn Argyl alumni, graduated Green Knights. So notice the rows of your peers, dressed in graduation gowns. Listen to the sound of your name being called. Savor the feel of your fresh diploma in your hands. Etch this final memory of Penn Argyl into your mind. And after today, you will face your new mountains and have new memories to make. A whole world opens up to you today. What hill you climb is up to you to decide. Thank you.
And now I would like to ask our senior chorus members to come forward. They will be singing the song titled "I Was Here" by Alan Billingsley.
Less, something that says.
now my privilege to introduce the class salutatorian, Miss Rebecca Stinson, whose speech is titled A Celebration.
To welcome all of you here today. On behalf of the class of 2019, thank you all for being with us on this monumental occasion. Before I get started, I have a bet to pay up. 4 years ago, I made a bet with my best friend that I would be valedictorian. It turns out that she was willing to turn up the competition, so now I owe her $5. So Krista, when you come up here later, there's a $5 bill waiting for you. Now that I've settled up, I can continue. Today is a celebration of all our accomplishments, our dedication, and our lives up to this point, as well as a celebration of the future and all its endless possibilities. It is a time to say thank you to those who have helped us become the people we are today, to our parents, our teachers, our peers, for being a part of our lives and seeing us through to this important milestone, in addition to preparing us for what lies ahead. Today is a celebration of our past. I have known so many of you since the first day of kindergarten. Many of us have made our best friends in this school. Look around to the people next to you. You've watched these people grow up. Watch them become the people they are today. We have all had different journeys along the way, different interests, different friends, different lives. But we all went through high school together. We have laughed together through wacky assemblies. It's not every day that you see your teacher get hypnotized to play an instrument, or watch a man pull five snakes out of a box. We also struggled together through the heat of early September and the freezing cold of April after the heat was turned off. We have mourned together through heartache and loss. We were challenged together and we grew together. We groaned about research papers and quizzes we forgot to study for. We raised money for Four Diamonds and participated in food and blood drives. We took action and were able to help our community together. We, as a class, have experienced so much together. Wherever you are going after today, remember the experiences you had in high school. Remember the people you met and thank those who had a role in your life. This is the last time all of us will be together in one place. Cherish your memories here, for they made you who you are today. Today is a celebration of our past, but it is also a celebration of the future. From this point on, all of us have a decision to make. What kind of lives do we want to live? What kind of future will you make for yourselves? From this point on, you have the power to control your life. High school has prepared you in more ways than you may realize. Struggling in school or at a sport or at a hobby has prepared you to face challenges in your future. You know what it is like to struggle, and you know that with hard work, you can make it through. Maybe high school allowed you to find a new interest or passion. Maybe you found your love of drawing or playing an instrument or reading. These passions don't have to end after high school. You learn to balance school with these other activities, and now you get the chance to do it in real life. Go and work towards your career, but don't forget the little things that bring you joy. If you learned that you love volunteering, then keep volunteering. If you found that you enjoy playing golf, then keep playing golf. I hope that you will become involved in whatever community you may end up in. Keep discovering new passions and always keep learning. So, class of 2019, today is our celebration because we have finally made it. the milestone that seemed so far off when we first stepped through the doors of Plainfield Elementary and were greeted with a warm welcome from Mr. G has been reached. Everything we experienced has made us into the strong and compassionate Green Knights that you see before you today. As we move on as Argyl alumni, we should never forget where we came from and never stop striving for something better in ourselves and our community, wherever our lives may take us. In the words of Henry David Thoreau, go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Live the life you have imagined. I wish you all the best of luck, and I thank you for everything.
It's now my honor to introduce class valedictorian, Ms. Krista Warfel, whose speech is titled Gratitude.
Got my $5. The best part of that was that I only remember betting one, so. Thank you everyone for joining us on this evening of celebration. I just would like to start off with a disclaimer. When Rebecca and I found out our class ranks freshman year, our plan, well, at least mine, was to be valedictorian, but have Becca write my speech. Needless to say, she opted out for some reason. So this is my first go at writing and presenting a formal speech. So just bear with me, please. Now, I am not one to withhold credit where credit is due. And I know I would not be standing here if not for the many people in my life that made this possible. So I would like to give them the thanks they deserve. First, I want to thank my parents and my family for always encouraging me and convincing me to finish that essay that I just really didn't want to write, and for reminding me that sleep is also important, and telling me to close the books and go to bed. I would like to thank my teachers and the administration. You are all incredible, and I am not going to get into the naming game because I know I will forget someone and feel bad. Thank you for teaching me to work hard and for being patient with me. And although not all your rooms had tissues for my mental breakdowns, thank you for being there to encourage me when I was overwhelmed. I would also like to give a huge thank you to my wonderful friends for blessing me with some of my most amazing memories of the bonfire, mini-thon, lunch, study halls where we played Uno, studied obviously, and you even made hard track practices fun. Thank you also for going through all the struggles of high school with me. Our class went through a lot of rough times together throughout our Argyl School District careers. And unfortunately, we have been through the tragic passings of two of our fellow classmates. And although their seats may be empty today, they will always be a part of our class in the memories that they have blessed us with. Lastly, I want to thank the most important reason for my success, God. I can stand up here and confidently say that I would not be where I am right now without God. He provided me with the strength and motivation to get through every rough patch I've encountered on this journey. Now, I want to talk about gratitude. I know personally, I spent too much of my high school time complaining. Wow, we have a terrible track. those hot school days where it was 95 degrees in your first period class had me just begging someone to turn on our non-existent air conditioning. Some days, I felt like I needed a gas mask because the smell of cat dissection seeping into the A-wing hallway was definitely making the air unbreathable. But now, as I think about going off to college, I am so grateful that I had the opportunity to go to Penn Argyl High School. We were blessed with a small community and with a caring faculty. Helen Keller once said, "So much has been given to me, I have no time to ponder over that which has been denied." If you focus on counting your blessings, you will realize that what you have is enough. But if you focus on complaining about what you don't have, you're going to live your life always unsatisfied. Going into this next stage of life, I would like to encourage all of us to remember that life is too short for complaining. Let's be grateful for what we have, when we have it, and hold on to the good memories that it gives us. So, in that spirit of positivity, I would like to give a shout out to the B-Wing Stairs for giving my legs muscles and my lungs great endurance. A huge thank you to that weird bell sound in the middle of the year that taught us all to adjust to change. Also, thanks to every snowstorm that came through and brought to our attention just how badly high schoolers can park their cars. And on a serious note, I would like to thank John Denver for writing the senior theme song, Country Roads. Country Roads became the theme song on every bus ride and the song that brought us shoulder to shoulder at all the dances. Now, we are brought shoulder to shoulder once again to show that we've made it. Even when some thought we would no passer on, we sulfured through and were able to passage. So on that cringy note, thank you everyone for your time and congratulations to the class of 2019.
At this time, I'd like to introduce Class Secretary, Kate Custer, and Class Treasurer, Alexa Brown, to present the gift from the Class of 2019.
Good evening. Over the last 13 years of our lives, our friends, family, and neighbors spent their time and spare change to support us in our fundraisers, like Pennies for Pasta and Fun Runs. It was fun in its own childish way, trying to beat our classmates for some Olive Garden. But we're adults now, and it's time to focus on more serious matters. That's why the class of 2019 would like to gift our remaining funds to a cause we know will impact many. As suggested by Mr. Domchek, we will be providing approximately $3,000 to support the construction of rooms to be used for mental health services that will be available to all needing students in the future. Additionally, we chose to donate $400 each to next year's sophomore, junior, and senior class for semi-formal decorations.
Baccalaureate was this past Sunday at Wingate Middle School. For those that attended, it was an enlightening service with Mr. Eli Tyler speaking to our class about the importance of living the best life for you and those around you. During the service, the offering was passed around to students and guests, where we collected over $300. This money, your money, will be given to Riley's Children's Hospital of Lehigh Valley. Thanks to your contributions, we raised enough money to enjoy our senior year with trips to Pocono Valley and New York and still give back. We would like to thank you for your generosity and encourage our fellow students to remember those who supported them in their journey and always remember to give back along the way. Thank you.
Class of 2019, thank you very much for your generosity by providing Penn Argyl High School this wonderful gift. Thank you. Can I ask Mr. Schlegel to please come to the podium? It's now my honor to introduce District Superintendent Mr. Wally Schlegel, who will provide the graduating class of 2019 with his final parting remarks, followed by the presentation of the class of 2019.
Thank you, David. Good evening, everyone. Tonight, on behalf of the school board and the administration, it's my pleasure to welcome the family and friends of the class of 2019. To the Penn Argyl Area School District class of 2019, I congratulate you on your accomplishment and your completion of your high school career. Tonight is a special night for many reasons. One, of course, this will be the last time that you gather as classmates. For your parents, this is also a special night. It's a night for them to look back over the last 13 years. In those 13 years, they made sure you arrived at school every day, made sure you did your homework every night, and they gave you the love and support you needed in every aspect of your life that made tonight possible. I would like to recognize our parents for a job well done. For our graduates, this is not the end of something, but simply the beginning of the next stage of your life. Some of you will begin careers, while others will continue with your education. In either case, your life will be full of new challenges. And in those challenges, you will at times inevitably face self-doubt. And that's normal. Your doubts will leave you pondering the safer choice, the more practical option, but perhaps not the best path. You all have the potential to overcome any challenge you face. The only true obstacle you face is letting self-doubt get in the way of your choice. Do not be afraid to fail. Never underestimate yourself. Never regret not taking an opportunity provided to you. When self-doubt begins to creep into your life, remember your successes. Remember how you overcame your anxiety and how your perseverance led to your accomplishments. From your successes, confidence is born. And when you have confidence, you have empowered yourself. The teachers and the staff here at the Penn Argyl Area High School have prepared you well for the next stage of life. And you will do well. Never have any regrets, what might have been. Challenge yourself to make the most of every opportunity. I wish the class of 2019 my best wishes. Thank you.
Mr. Schlegel, it gives me great pleasure, pride, and honor to present you with the graduating class of 2019. These assembled students, whose names will soon be announced, have met all the graduation requirements of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the School Board of the Penn Argyl Area School District, and I declare them worthy to receive their high school diploma.
As superintendent of the Penn Argyl Area School District, I accept Mr. Domchek's recommendation and certify to Mr. Robert Lutt, president of the Board of Education, that the members of the class of 2019 who are present this evening have satisfied the obligations and requirements necessary to be awarded a high school diploma from the Argyl Area School District. Mr. Rutt, will you please come to the podium?
I accept the recommendation and certification rendered to me this evening from Superintendent Schlegel, and the members of the class of 2019 present here this evening are eligible to be awarded a diploma from the Argyl Area School District. Congratulations, you're all alumni. The Board of Education and the Argyl Area School District, to its administrators, faculty, and staff, to the family members and guests gathered here tonight, to the class of 1969 and the class of 2019, I'd like to welcome you all to this evening's ceremonies. I'm sure one word that you have all been hearing lately is the word ready. Are you ready for prom? Are you ready for the Keystones? I'm so ready to take the Noxie exam. Are you ready to party after graduation? Probably the most used word the last few weeks of your educational career here at Argyl has been ready. Ready implies preparedness, an eagerness to do something, a confidence to reach a goal. There's a sense of excitement and some butterflies in your gut. You wonder if you've gotten everything prepared correctly, but you're going to do it. You're going to give it your best shot, and hopefully you'll even enjoy it a little. There's only one person gathered here tonight who's more ready than you, and that would happen to be Mr. Philip Giaquino. This man has spent 1 year shy of a quarter century in education and has rendered 18 years to the Argyl Area School District as its principal. I have seen this man in an inflatable sumo suit. I have seen him screaming at the top of his lungs on the roof of his building. I have seen him pied. And I have seen hordes of robots scurrying down the hallway chasing each other. You don't see this normally in elementary school. But this man's motto is success begins here. It's the foundation of 13 years of education for this class. So at this time, class of 2019, will you please join me in a round of applause for the retirement of Mr. Giaquino. Ready also contains fear, a host of concerns, high emotions, even a few tears. 75 years ago, the American soldiers in their landing craft approaching France were scared beyond belief, but they were ready. Every first responder in this area is nervous when called for, but their training and experience have made them ready. Here at Argyl, we have worked hard as a team to make you ready for graduation. That group that who have helped you are your parents, your teachers, your friends, and your teammates. We all have worked hard together to prepare you both academically and socially to move forward with whatever the next step of your life will be. Our purpose is to have you ready for college, the workforce, the service, or family. Our goal for you is to be a success. So, seniors, or alumni now, are you having any doubts? Are you looking in that black hole called the future and saying, whoa, 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 no one told me about this? Well, that's true, we didn't. We're not fortune tellers. But what we did do is to show you how to behave in these situations by being role models and sharing our experiences and showing how we handled similar situations. It'll be up to you to do the right thing. After all, no one can really prepare you for the moment when someone special gets down on one knee with a little velvet box in their hands. That accident where you're going to get hurt. Your first diaper change. But your classmates and the lessons taught at Argyl will certainly help you be confident and you will succeed. So to close, allow me to give you a few readies to always have in your back pocket. Be ready to help your community. Be ready to take a chance to be successful in your career. Be ready to support each other. Be ready to hold your breath when you change that diaper. Be ready to have fun. And always, always be ready to smile. Congratulations, class of 2019.
Okay, we are now at the part of this evening's ceremony that's the most important and exciting, the diploma presentation of the class of 2019. This is a very special time for our graduates, parents, family members, and teachers. Please applaud and respond politely so each and every graduate has the opportunity to hear their name announced. Please wait until all of our graduates have been announced, at which time you will have the opportunity to enthusiastically congratulate all of our graduates. Mrs. Hance, will you please come to the podium and do us the honor of reading the names of the graduates of the class of 2019.
Ms. Warfel, please rise. We will begin the diploma presentation with the class valedictorian, Krista Lee Warfel. Class salutatorian, Rebecca Jane Stinson. Class president, Nathan James Dale. Class vice president, Anderson J. Deer. Class secretary, Cade Richard Custer. Class treasurer, Alexia Marie Brown. Recipient of the Principal's Award, Angelica Liberta. Recipient of the Diane Kovaleski Memorial Scholarship, Daniel R. Musselman. Tad Barr will be receiving the diploma for Jonathan P. Antinoli. Jordan Sims will be receiving the diploma for Santino Vincent Tamaro. Jacob Abruzzese. Jordan Abruzzese. Austin M. Ashenfelder. Tad Allen Barr. Rebecca Lynn Bartholomew. Cade A. Bartolacci. Felicity Love Billig. Yeah. Shayla Berger. Isabella Bowers. Lexis Madison Seal Brownstein. Sophia N. Buba. Kirsten Noel Buchta. Chase Caesar. Ashley N. Capone. Emily Castano. Simona Shavdarova. Alyssa M. Campano. Jason D. Corona. Michael A. Corsetti. Tyler Lee Crawford. Angela Grace Culver. Cody Danner. Jake Matthew Davis. Benjamin Michael Davison. Joseph M. DiPaolo. Adriana R. DeReamer. Nolan Dieter. Heather DeLeo. Samuel Does. Jessica Alana Drovich. Sarah Ann Eckhart. Morgan Faith Edelman. Sydney Ann Edelman. Carson S. Engler. Joshua Fallows. Connor Fallows. Kira Lynn Finden. Erin Catherine Firestone. Matthew Montgomery Fisher. Kristen Marie Frieda. Abigail Elaine Fritz. Jacob Michael Glose. Gianna Lynn Grego. Lillian Marie Gruber. Nicholas J. Guerri, Jr. Corinne Gabriella Guide. Shania Heckman. Nicholas R. Henriksen. Mackenzie Henry. Kyler Stephen Horn. Gianna Matrice Iani. Brielle A. Incalcaterra. Hannah Mackenzie Irwin. Jocelyn May Itterly. Micah Jones. Nathan James Jones. Robert M. Kasmar, Jr. Vincent G. Kuiper. Jacqueline Elizabeth Curler. Annalise Aurora Akalu Appalachia Kernosh. Pacey Hayden Kessler. Alexis Kiris. Brandon Robert Kleiling. Stephen Kumbarov. Connor Joseph Kupris. Austin M. Labar. Sydney Catherine Lakey. Gabrielle Langlois. Amanda Larson. Colin A. Layton. Chevelle Leanne Licklider. Mehmed Letifo. Eric Thomas Lobb. Ty Lutz. Ryan Thomas McCauley. Kylie Madison McCaig. Kiana Lee Mamrak. Alessandra Markison. Sydney Camille Melham. Melissa M. Miles. Jessica Elizabeth Miller. Alyssa Marie Molina. Oriana Mondello. Kaylee Moore. Christopher T. Morris. Damon H. Mutka. Michael Nolf. Caesar O'Brien. Kelly Marie O'Brien. Angel Ocampo. Sarah Olzinski. Madison R. Pados. Lindsay Parker. Robson Pereira. Daniel Jeffrey Pfeiffer. Yeah. Amanda May Peischer. Sarah E. Riegel. Lauren Elise Riduzzi. Brandon Reed. Mackenzie Renner. Gianni M. Rito. Brandon Riley. Destiny Latte Robbins. Travis J. Roberts. Taylor Jessica Rudy. Lexi Rochelle Sapone. Tanner Brian Shaw. Matthew R. Silliman. Mackenzie Marie Silvius. Jordan Tysier Sims. Alyssa Singleton. Jacob Slaughter. Elizabeth Rose Snuggs. Amelia Stanmitz. Michael Vandegrift. Timothy James Vilecki Jr. Emily Elizabeth Voigt. Gabrielle Patricia Weaver. Corey Robert Werner.
Okay, how about a big round of applause for our graduates? Come on, we can do much better than that. My privilege to invite Vice President of the Class of 2019, Anderson Deer, to lead his classmates in the tassel ceremony.
Good evening, class of 2019. Today marks the completion of our high school career, and I'm sure we can all look back on good times and bad times, whether it be an amazing field trip or finishing a paper the day before it's due. We all have memories that we will look back on for years to come. Although as a class, we have one more memory to make before we can officially close the book on high school. At this time, I ask you all to please rise, and on my countdown, we'll turn our tassels from right to left as we ourselves turn from high school students into graduates. 3, 2, 1.
And now please join our concert band under the direction of Mr. Reike as they lead us in the Pan Argyl Area High School alma mater. Following the alma mater, President Nathan Dale will lead the graduates of the class of 2019 in the cap toss, after which the class of 2019 will leave the field to the song Impact by Sean O'Loughlin.
I'm hungry now.
Yeah, I'm hungry.